Let's go to degustation night at the Art House. Degustation. What is degustation all about?
A degustation is a sampling of a menu, and quite often it's paired with the drinks. Usually it's with wines, but in this case we're doing it with cocktails.
Right. Now I should get stuck into that because that's actually got a lime granita, which is
a sugar syrup with lime juice.
This particular cocktail using gin, just a little whisper of lime liqueur and a kaffir lime just to give it some added lime complexity.
The sharpness of the gimlet and the sharpness of the oyster have really married quite well together.
This first course designed to be very palate cleansing.
So let's move on to the next course. We have the pan-seared scallop here.
It's an old classic made for Tony Bennett at Caesar's Palace in Las Vegas. It has the added ingredient of clamato, or a clam stock, essentially made into a tomato broth, a spicy tomato broth with a clam stock. So, you know, you've got a nice kind of crossing of flavours of the shellfish. We've got some nice shellfish in the drink, as well as obviously in the canapé, as well as a multiple tie-in with the tomato.
Tomato is actually quite soft in that.
Lovely savoury quality.
And yet again, yeah, the tomatoes kind of blends it in together.
Yeah, a subtlety of flavour, it works best, certainly.
So the next course,
it is actually this course, the duck here.
It's roasted duck, and we've got a blood orange marmalade on there. And it's on brioche.
And certainly this cocktail here just has a nice kind of rich flavour, the Grand Marnier, hint of Campari just to give it a bit of bitterness, blood orange juice, which is a gorgeous kind of subtle bittersweet juice as well. Just a little whisper of elderflower cordial there just to kind of lift it in the
floral tones. Very, very nice.
So yeah, really it's all about kind of duck and orange this course.
Salut. It's great, the sweetness and the duck have always worked well together, and you get that right off the bat. Taste the accompaniment, obviously. Now, I do notice the bitterness, and it almost plays with, the slight fattiness that duck has, the natural fattiness that duck has, and the sweetness of the orange marmalade, and it's really kind of married well together. Whatever possessed you guys to say, hey, well, you know, you can drink cocktails with food, why?
The main thing about cocktails and food is you can get a much tighter match between the flavours because, you know, where it's wines, for example, you know, there's subtleties of flavour that really you rely on some of the acidity or fruitiness of the wine to kind of lend itself to a savoury flavour. Through cocktails and infusion of spices and vegetables and herbs, you can really get to the heart of the flavour match. And you've got such a tight marriage of flavour that you can't get with just a wine degustation. Not to say it's any better, and it's just to say it's different. And so I think you can get an added complexity of flavour in the drink with the dish, and I think the way they come together in the mouth is, you know, a much tighter match, I guess, is how you would best characterise it.
Now, let's see what happens when Ben adds a little coriander to the mix.
Now we take a sturdy mixing glass, one whole sprig of fresh coriander. Just going to kind of break it up. I'm going to use my flat-ended bar spoon just to crush that up and release some of those fresh coriander oils and flavour. We're going to introduce here about 6 to 8 lime wedges, crushing there to release some of the fresh lime juice. Come in with the chartreuse, 30 mils. By 30 mils of liqueur de pomme verte. And 15 mils of absinthe. The absinthe really is the curveball here that helps kind of give the drink some added complexity. To this now, I'm just adding 30 mil of white cranberry.
This has become quite a popular juice to be using nowadays, the white cranberry.
Look, it's a little bit sweeter and less tart than the red cranberry. I'm just gonna give that a nice shake. I'm gonna reach for our double strainer here and really just kind of...
Is that so you don't have the actual pieces of the coriander floating through it? Bit too
pretty much it. We don't want people kind of having to pick things out of their teeth. Just going to lay a fresh piece of coriander there.
Looks frightening, like kryptonite. Should I be worried that I'm going to lose my powers at trying this one?
Cheers.
Very, very lovely. Thank you, the apple, that apple liqueur really has softened it, and the lime has kind of, I guess, taken the sharpness out of the absinthe and chartreuse, yep, and kind of balanced it very, very nicely. Well, there we go. Another winner from the cocktail chef, Ben Davidson.